Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Tuesday, July 7th, 2009. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the things we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Let me first explain that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade in their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. What you now see are the Euro-USD currency charts as they looked at 7:45 a.m. New York time on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform using the FX Bootcamp custom layout. From left to right, the 15-minute chart, the 1-minute chart, and an hourly chart with daily pivot points. What I notice at this time, I'm showing here on the 15-minute chart on the left, the Euro-USD has reached the M4 pivot point. Now that is a top, that is a source of resistance and a common top for an uptrending day, which is exactly what we've had since the London Open. But there's more going on at that level near 140.45 than just M4. And you can see that on the longer term charts. Here are some longer term charts, daily chart on the left, for a 4-hour chart with weekly pivot points in the middle, and on the right, a 2-hour chart. Now, it's the 4-hour chart with the weekly pivot points that really has my attention. This horizontal black line on the weekly pivot points chart, that is the weekly central pivot point positioned this week at 40.35, 1.4035. I'm also seeing this downward sloping gray line. That's the upper Bollinger Band on the 4-hour chart. Now notice how the upper Bollinger Band on the 4-hour chart and this weekly central pivot point are converging near the position of today's daily M4 pivot point. So you've got three sources of logical resistance all coming together at, remember the time I just mentioned earlier, 7:45 a.m. New York time? That's 15 minutes prior to what is generally recognized as the open of the New York session. So here's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking that if the U.S. dollar is going to rally against the euro, a rally on the dollar means down on this currency pair. If the dollar is going to rally against the euro, this is the right place, again, an area with multiple sources of resistance near 140.50, and the right time, the open of the New York session, for that rally in the dollar to start. I'm also thinking that with no major U.S. news on today's New York session calendar, plus U.S. corporate earnings reports for the second quarter right around the corner, maybe the market isn't quite ready yet to get ahead of itself by continuing the increase in risk appetite theme we saw during the European session against the major currency pairs. In other words, I was anticipating a range-bound day for the currency markets. Again, up during London, maybe down in the case of the Euro-USD, down during the New York session. Let's go back to the Euro charts. Several minutes later, just before 8 a.m. in New York, we get a 5A cross, a cross of the 5 EMA below the 8 SMA on the 1-minute chart. And that happened to coincide also with a MACD cross. So two nearly identically in time sources of confirmation that the M4 pivot point in combination with also the upper Bollinger Band on the 4-hour chart in the vicinity again of the weekly central pivot point, that area around 40.50 holding as resistance. These signals I used to confirm that the area was going to hold, and I used those as my trigger to get in on a short trade on this candle right here. So if you took the shot, you might have been in somewhere about here, about, let's say, 140.43, 1.4043 for your entry. And in terms of an exit strategy, your stop is not far above today's high. Switching now to a 3-minute chart, which I love using to identify intraday levels of support and resistance. You can see how the rest of this first trade transpired. So we're in just above 40.40, You get dropping price down to the 40-15 area. At this point, you're already break even. Stop move to break even from a position just above today's high. And this move up here, this rise to lower high, that presented a second opportunity to get in. Now, I've identified this line just above 140.30. Actually, it's a horizontal gray line positioned at 140.33 because of that reaction right there. That suggests the possibility of a previous source of support at 140.33. And sure enough, that level of apparent support becomes resistance. So you have some role reversal there. What was support becoming resistance, and also a fib level there of the move down from today's high. The horizontal blue line right here represents the 61.8% retracement of the move down from today's high at 40.50 to the swing low at 40.13. So your entry, an optional second entry on a short trade, somewhere right in here. Maybe you're filled at 40.30, maybe you're filled as high as, say, 40.33. And you could use a one-minute chart similar to how we described using it just a moment ago. You can use a cross of indicators on the one-minute chart to confirm that 40.33 area was holding as resistance. Price continued down to what I identified in the live class as my first profit target. I had 39.80 identified. More specifically, is this 39.75 to 39.80 area right in here. Hold on, let's get rid of the FIP study. Okay, my initial profit zone was right in here, 30.75 to 30.80. And the reason why is shown at the time on the hourly chart. Let's take a look at that. At the time, we had the 55 EMA on the hourly chart. That's the upper sloping blue line in this hourly chart with pivot points. The 55 EMA at the time was positioned, as I recall, at 139.79. And just below it, and you can see it on this hourly chart, just below it was the 21 EMA. And you can also see the 8 SMA on this hourly chart there as well. So that was my profit target for those reasons. Several moving averages converged together in one area. Logical source of support in the context of the uptrend which had been in place prior to today's New York Open. So in at 140.44, out at 139.80 for a profit of roughly 60 pips. Hey, not bad at all on a day without news, but that wasn't it. We had one more chance. About 1 hour later, we were eyeing yet another opportunity to short the Euro-USD. Let's take a look at that. Here's the 3-minute chart we are watching. At about this point, we were watching price rise from the 39.80 area. And I was pointing out some of the price action prior to this point, which occurred especially during the London lunch session. I'm seeing a swing low there, or a retest of the 40.10 area in here. And I'm seeing what some traders call a hiccup in price right there. So my premise was this: the 40.10 area, 1.4010, might become a source of resistance. So I drew a line there. You can also use Fibonacci levels to consider what Fibonacci traders might identify there. If you do a FIP study of the move down from today's high to the swing low at 139.72, you learn that the 50% retracement of that move down, represented by the horizontal green line, is nearly a near perfect overlap with that 40.10 area. You can also do a different FIP study based on the swing high in the 40.35 area. That FIP study points to a 61.8% retracement of the move down from 40.35 down to 39.72. So FIB levels and previous support and previous resistance all point to 40.10 being potentially an important area. And if you're looking to short, you want to short at level resistance, and that's a level resistance. Price action and FIB levels suggest that could be a level of resistance for multiple reasons. And you had to be quick on this one. Price actually rises to 140.09. You see the near touch of the 40.10 area there. Again, you could use the one-minute chart in the same fashion. A 5.8 cross in the one-minute chart would have put you in closer to 140, somewhere in here. again, using the one-minute chart the same way we use it to identify the original entry just before the open of the New York session. And from there, the rest was history. Down, down, down we go to what I identified sometime before this last entry as a final target, the daily central pivot point just below 39.50. And we hit that. I've identified the daily central pivot point with the horizontal black line here. We hit that just minutes after today's lending close, represented by the vertical red line. So for that second trade in and about 140, maybe as high as, say, 140.08. Let's say in at 140 if you're conservative, if you wait for confirmation on the one-minute chart of the bounce in the 140.10 area. In at 140, out at 139.50 for a profit of just under 50 pips after accounting for spread. And that was it. All the other many other major pairs moved just as well. Strength in the yen, some strength in the dollar against other currencies. Risk aversion was the theme during today's New York session. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Tuesday, July 7th.